Mich hat an dem Film die Bildsprache sofort gepackt, ne? Also die Art und Weise, wie die beiden Figuren so in Beziehung oder beziehungsweise dann eben nicht in Beziehung zueinander gesetzt werden. Der Film ist ja wie so ein Bergwerk, aus dem man unterschiedliche Aspekte sich halt rausschöpft, ne? Als Teenager war das der optimale Pubertätsfilm, weil es ja auch darum geht, warum Liebe eigentlich gar nicht funktioniert, zumindest nicht auf längere Sicht. Und das traf ja wirklich sehr, sehr gut so mein Lebensgefühl. Ne? Es gibt auf jeden Fall eine Szene auf einer Party, wo Leute so ein Partyspiel machen. Und da hat mich halt einfach die Idee begeistert, dass halt der Regisseur diese Figuren halt auch so benutzt, eigentlich mehr wie in so einem Spiel, gar nicht in so einer psychologischen Konstellation, sondern dass es halt mehr wie so eine Versuchsanordnung funktioniert und der Film trotzdem hoch emotional ist. Antonioni ist wirklich ein großer Held. Also darf er nicht vergessen, dass viele von seinen Regiekollegen in Italien ihn ja wirklich auch gehasst haben, auch dafür. Orson Welles sprach immer von der Sünde des Antonioni, die halt darin besteht, dass man halt so aus Orson Welles Sicht kaltherzig auch mit seinen Figuren umgeht. Ne? Haneke spricht halt von der Vergletscherung der Gefühle und Antonioni hat die halt schon in den 60ern prognostiziert und auch ganz eng mit dem Industriezeitalter auch verknüpft. Und von dem her finde ich ihn halt schon sehr visionär. Also feststeht, als er halt La Notte gedreht hat, war er schon so ein Nabel der europäischen Filmkultur und mit Sicherheit auch einer, der wirklich sehr weitsichtig viel da schon einfach begriffen hat. Ne? Und der Film wirkt ja auch, wenn man den heute sieht, wirkt er ja auch mit seinen Kameraperspektiven und Bildideen immer noch sehr modern und nicht jetzt bildsprachlich antiquiert.
La Notte is for me a very wonderful gift. In a way, it was a collaboration with Manfred Eicher that he had been for so many years using some of my music for the different settings with Jean-Luc Godard and Anne-Marie Mierville. And I was thinking about myself trying to make music inspired by film. And I had this Antonioni, the early films of Antonioni in my mind, and asked Manfred if that could be something for him, and he was very positive. And I got this chance to make a big concert at the Molde Jazz Festival that year, and I like also live recordings. I was very happy that Manfred opened for that possibility. One never knows, it can be awful, but if you succeed, it can also be a special energy. The full concert was too long for a full CD, I think. So we had the Rainbow Studio coming up to deconstructing the material and finding a CD format for it. Of course, not the whole concert, but half of it, I think. More than half of it, actually, it was not so much we took away. Yeah, perhaps one fourth, I think, we took away. It is a kind of a certain feeling. I think it's something also with the rhythm in his films. He has a kind of slow intensity. So I was thinking about that it's not always about tempo to be intense, but finding language for the music that is more or less inspired by it. One shouldn't overload the inspiration either. One should just put Antonioni as a frame for something. I have some different scenes in my head. I had that when I wrote the music also. I had something from La Notte, I had from other films that inspired me for the compositions. What is interesting is that my grandmother, she was a silent movie piano player in a small city in Norway in the older days, in the 20s and 30s. And at that time, the music was often very stormy because it was not that high quality silent movies, but it was very much a drama. And then they picked up different music for that. I did a film about the silent movie of Victor Sjöström, the wonderful man who made the Terje Vigen in 1917. I played it around many places in the world, actually, in Barbican and in France, Norway. And that is quite stormy music because so much is happening. I'm thinking that, for instance, some of the scenes in the Antonioni films are very intense. But this is also, I hope, some moments of real contemplation and silence in the album. Every single piece was composed in that sense that it had a melody, but it had an open structure, as very much is in improvised music, that you get the possibility to improvise, but mostly on the chords and sometimes on quite free things also. Antonioni is one of the most important for me. I saw everything he did in the 60s, and I have had him as a favorite for many, many years. It would be many other choices, but I am still very happy that we ended up with Antonioni.